sophomore album was Never Take Friendship Personal, right? Yes. Is there any story behind the title of that?
Well, a couple things, like, you know, the major kind of the reason that I wrote the song was actually because between the first record and the second record, we had to get rid of a member because he was more or less in rock and roll for sex, drugs, and rock and roll, you know? Mm-hmm. And for us, it wasn't like that. We just didn't want that. That wasn't the lifestyle that we wanted to live, and that's not who we were or who we were becoming. And so after letting him go, it was really, really tough on the band. Like, the it wasn't like an amiable thing, you know? It was a very hard breakup, like, as far as... and anybody will tell you, like, being in a band is like, you know, being married, you know, because you spend so much time with that person you are. And so he really, there was a lot of, like, slander and hatred and just all this stuff that came with it. None of us were expecting it, you know, like, oh, I can't believe this, you know. And so that really took a toll on the band. And so for a second there, we all got a little bitter, I think, a little shook up. Like, man, who are our friends now? Especially when you get, like, a buzz or when people start talking about your band. Suddenly you have a ton of friends, you know what I'm saying? Because of, you know, whether they think they can get money from you or some type of notoriety or whatever, you know, they perceive your band to be. You know, it seems you collect a lot of friends, you know, as soon as the buzz hits. And we were suddenly dealing with that. You know, we had to fire a manager. You know, we were switching booking agents. All this stuff was just hitting us at once. And it was just like, we recluse into ourselves, just the four of us. We're like, okay, we got to reevaluate, see who our friends are. Mm-hmm. And I think from that moment, you know, of reevaluation is where, you know, the title and everything came from, Never Take Friendship Personal.
Okay, very cool. So, and now you've named your new album Cities.
Right.
And any reason why that title,
yeah,
Cities?
I mean, it was such a transformation. I think it was, the original title is Songs for Darker Places, and then it went Songs for Darker Cities, and then Darker Cities, and then Dark Cities, and that sounded too much like Batman, so we were just like, okay, Cities it is. But the reason I came up with it was because that I felt like with like cities, you know, there's, especially with like things like New York City or LA or something like that, you look at those two cities and you say, you know, like, it feels so insurmountable, like, those are so big, you know, what problems am I going to face, can I ever even make it there, you know, or what would I do, or who would I be, and stuff like that. I think that's, you know, I equate that a lot like life, you know, like every city has a different culture, a different feel, you know, whether it's Seattle or Tokyo or Japan, like every city's going to feel different in some way. And of course there's lessons you can learn from the city or something that someone can teach you. And I guess that's what I wanted about each and every song, is just kind of like each and every song I wanted to be different in some way, whether it's a different story or different musically. And then at the end of the day, I wanted it to teach a lesson, you know, whether about a failure and success, about not giving up, or about depression, or no matter what the subject was, you know, I kind of wanted people to walk away feeling a little bit more like, you know, than this is just music. I wanted it to be more like, hey, this actually meant something to me. I actually got something out of this. And so I think that's where the name Cities derived from.
And so what are some of the topics that you discussed in Cities?
Well, I mean, this is the first song, Godspeed, is about drug use and stuff like that, just about, you know, dealing with and seeing people fall and fail. And even for me, just looking at, like, past rock stars and stuff like that who have been so affected, whether it's, like, you know, in there it talks a lot, the song kind of alludes to several musicians, like, I think Lou Reed and Sid Vicious, and there's a whole bunch of different, you know, band members that I felt like, you know, kind of destroyed, you know, music as, you know, or themselves, you know. I mean, you have a list of rock stars from Jim Morrison to, you know, there was Billie Holiday, John Coltrane, John Bonham, all these musicians who were just amazing musicians destroyed their lives because of drugs. And it was just, to me, it was just like, how egotistical and how self-centered can one possibly be, you know? Who knows what poetry, you know, Ian Curtis could have came up with after this, you know. I'm not here to judge, you know, like, I understand that each people have their own vices and demons, but it just felt like, for me, it was just kind of like, hey, let me take these lessons of the past, apply them to my life, and then teach people for the future, you know, just to realize that, you know, drugs are not a source of inspiration, but of self-destruction and mutilation. So.
Thank you. Anberlin's third album debuted on Billboard charts at number 19. Even though the guys are slowly moving their way to stardom, nothing has changed about their personalities. They're all still as down to earth as when they started 5 years ago. This is Anberlin's first single off their album Cities. This is Godspeed.
You got what you really got.
Thanks for checking out MIA, Music and Interview Affairs. I'm your host, Jess Tack, and thanks for supporting the underground music scene.